said there'd be no state funds at all in terms of paying off Jeff's contract. Also the case, I assume, with the new coach.
Correct. There are no state funds involved in Calhoun, in any of our operation, any of any way to shape it.
And sort of the related question, how much is urgency, for lack of a better word, is there financially because of the investments you guys have made in the city and the trade facility?
Certainly, we have financial capital. There's no escaping that. I'll go back to the beginning. This decision was made with our student athletes in mind and providing them conditions for success and creating success in our football program. And then those other things will follow.
Jonathan Gerber, Daily Cal. You keep saying that the decision was made with the student athletes in mind. Did you take the input at all? And if so, what was their input?
As an athletic director, and obviously I have a team of other staff that support our football program on a daily basis, you can certainly get student athlete input without asking for it. You can discern it. But when I say that this was made with them in mind, it was made. And I said this to them this morning. I said, I had the unenviable task of deciding on your behalf. Okay? And I had to decide with them in mind, thinking about them, thinking about what is best for creating conditions for success for them. So this was not a matter of them saying what they wanted or didn't want, but it was me thinking about analyzing and deciding what would provide those conditions.
And what was their reaction this morning?
They're disappointed. Jeff and his coaching staff have been their leaders. Most of them were recruited by somebody on the staff. It's what they've known. But I also challenged them about what's next. And I believe that they will respond. They love Cal. They love this institution. In time, they will look forward to what's next. They need time to figure out their emotions about this. I would expect nothing less than them being very disappointed.
John Bridge, John
Bridge, CBS Sports. Have you set a timeline for the new hire? And you guys, if you have that by this week, so that all the teams are still playing, is that work to your advantage? Is there a timeline for the new hire?
As expeditiously as we possibly can. Timing is of the essence, and all of this timing was critical related to the decision, and being fair to Jeff and to the staff, and what we needed to do if the decision was going to be to search for a new head coach. Obviously, a lot of folks are still playing this weekend. Some folks are still playing next weekend. So we'll have to edit that. But we will do this as quickly as we possibly can, but not sacrificing getting the right person to lead.
John, go ahead.
That was my question.
Oh, that was my question.
Yeah.
Mine?
Yeah. Thank you. Sammy, Jeff has had considerable turnover on his staff over the years, and he took a couple of really big hits this past year. How much of that is on him, and how much of that is systemic, is because of the system, the way it's set up in terms of finances for systems?
Certainly continuity in the coaching staff is important. You ask any AD, ask any head football coach, that'll be on their list. In terms of my or our accountability, that certainly is a place where we attempt to continue to analyze the competitive marketplace and stay competitive, and we will certainly commit to doing that. We've taken a look at where we are in the marketplace of an entire pool of assistant coaches, we're pretty good. We're not up top, but we're certainly not anywhere near bottom either.
When a school comes in and doubles the salary of one of your assistants to take it away, are you in any position to do anything about that, or is it just financial reality that you can't?
Well, I think as we're all aware, we provided what I felt was a pretty good competitive offer in the situation you're referring to, and ultimately we were not in a position, and shouldn't have been in a position to have a contract.
Jim? Is there a protocol for contacting purchasing of agents that are still playing, and along that line, have you received much input about interest out there in the competition?
This is a funny business, that way. And there is a protocol that I'm talking to head coaches, and it is before I will have a conversation with any head coach. I will have the permission of their infrastructure, or at minimum, I will have contacted their athletic director and sought permission. You don't typically get turned down. It might be, yes, you can talk to them, but after they're done this weekend, and we will honor that. We will absolutely honor that. So it's, and then the second part of your question was about interest. We've received great interest in a very short period of time today. Unfortunately, this is part of this business that I do not care for at all. We received interest long before the job was even open, of which we did not respond to in any way, shape, or form.
Yeah. In other schools I know have used headhunting firms in this sort of situation. I'm wondering, Ron, if you will do that. It kind of is a way in between. And secondly, a head college football coach at the top level now has become increasingly complicated, tough job. In looking at the resumes of people, what do you put at the top of the resume that you look at first? So those two questions.
The answer to the first question is yes. We have hired a search consultant, an executive search firm, to assist us with this search. And then, you know, in reference to your own question, it's a complex. It has become a very complex job. So it's really difficult to put one thing at the top. But I think there are a number of things which I talked about in answering one of the previous questions. In terms of characteristics and qualities, and I would put football expertise at the top because of this institution. But again, you've got a set of characteristics that we have to meet all of them, and significant football demonstrated football expertise and success is certainly on there. But it's integrity, it's team builder, character builder, staff builder, it's innovator, it's visionary.
You wouldn't put one at the top, though? I mean, you're making a hire, and you've done, you know, your records speaks for itself on that, but you wouldn't put one?
I would not put one at the top because I have done all.
Okay.
Dan Greenspan, Fox Sports. In terms of the NFL, NFL head coaches, NFL assistants, how would that affect the timetable and what's the process like for potentially interviewing them?
Yeah, the NFL piece gets a little bit more complicated because they are going deeper into the season. They don't have the same kinds of restrictions related to when you can contact and when you can't in terms of ownership and some other things. So that's up to each guy, I would think. So we'll, you know, if there's an NFL guy that we can fit our criteria, we'll sort through that.
Yes, Sammy, this would be your first football hire here
at Cal.
At Cal, yes. And how much is the most important hire an AD does typically in school? How much pressure or responsibility do you feel goes into that for you?
It's a huge responsibility that I embrace on behalf of this institution. Football is incredibly important to us, not only as a department, but as a university, emotionally, financially. It's, there is no other place on this campus that 65,000 people gather on any given Saturday afternoon or evening. It occupies a very, very important role and an important place in this university. And so finding new leadership for that program is really terribly, terribly important, and we will be very serious and very diligent about hiring the right leader.
Right. When did you personally reach the decision, and what was the timeline moving forward?
Again, we, in
Was there a specific turning point during the season when you started thinking that you might not be back next year? Was it more gradual, or was it something that you entered the season thinking, given the team's lead in record the last 4 or 5 years?
Well, I certainly entered the season with high hopes and high expectations about where we were headed, and I know Jeff did, and I know our community did. I'm a body of work person, both from a career standpoint and the time to Cal, as well as from a season-long perspective. So it certainly where we were going, and then ultimately the 3-9 are we're concerned. But I don't think there was a point where I said this is the truth. Because again, we were going to conclude the season and then have the conversations, do the analysis, and reach a conclusion, which is what we're doing.
John.
Yes, Tim, during the 2 days that you met with Jeff to discuss the program, is there anything he said about what the state of the program needs that you will now use as you look for the success?
There were a lot of things that Jeff and I talked about, and I would say all of them are things that Jeff and I have continued to talk about throughout. One of the things that I really appreciated about Jeff's and my relationship was that we would always talk about how can we get better? What does the program need? We certainly strive to, from a resource standpoint, from a conditions for success standpoint, be in the proper market position. We've done that under Jeff's leadership, and we'll do that under new leadership as well.
Based on the caliber of employees you've had so far, the caliber of the candidates, how confident are you at being able to bring in a top-notch guy that can meet these characteristics that you've put forth?
This is a great job. It's been made better by Jeff. This is a very attractive job that is and will attract a number of folks, a number of candidates that will be the director, and we'll have an opportunity to make a
change. Any more questions?